The next thing that we're going to create is going to be our wall script. This is going to allow our player to destroy wall tiles if they become trapped or to create other paths through the map. We're going to go to Create, C# Script in our Scripts folder, and we'll call this Wall. We'll open that up in MonoDevelop. In MonoDevelop, we're going to start by declaring some variables. We're going to declare a public sprite called DamageSprite. This is the sprite that we're going to display once the player has hit the wall so that the player can see that they've successfully attacked the wall. We're also going to declare a public integer called HP for hit points, and we're going to initialize that to 4. Next, we're going to declare a private variable of the type SpriteRenderer called SpriteRenderer. We're going to change our start function to an awake function, and we're going to get and store a component reference to our sprite renderer in sprite renderer. We can delete our update function. Next, we're going to declare a public function that returns void called DamageWall that takes an integer parameter called loss. In DamageWall, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to set the sprite of our sprite renderer to our damaged sprite. This is going to give the player some visual feedback that they've successfully attacked the wall. Next, we're going to subtract loss from this wall's current hit points total. We're going to check if HP is less than or equal to 0, and if it is, we're going to use GameObject.setActive to disable the game object. Let's save our script and return to the editor. In the editor, let's return to our prefabs folder, and we're going to add our wall script. We'll select wall 1 through wall 8 by shift-clicking, and then we'll go to Component, Scripts, Wall. There are several ways to add a script to a game object. We're using this method to avoid confusion with the scripts in the completed folder of the same name. Next, we'll set the damaged sprite to the respective damaged sprites for each of our wall tiles. If you add the sprites to walls 1 through 8 in the order that they're found in the sprite sheet, they should match up. So there we have it. Now we have walls that our player can interact with and destroy. And in the next video, we're going to set up the player animation controller.